Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Now, I want to ask you, is this wire having electric power flowing right now?
Yes.
And when I touch it, did I get any current?
No.
Am I confident in touching it?
Yes.
Why?
Because you know. Outside
I know what?
Bad conductor, yeah.
That it, there is an insulation,
yes.
And it's a bad conductor.
Yes.
Yes.
In the same way, the spiritual laws operate on what you know. Every action that we ever take is based on what I know. Praise God.
Praise God.
So there is a law of faith and there is a law of fear. Just like the electric power flowing through this cable, the law of faith is when God's power begins to flow, and the law of fear is where the powers of darkness comes to destroy. Can you just settle down, please? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So yesterday we were studying that in Romans chapter 8 verse 2, that there are two spiritual laws operating, but both operating on the opposite side. And these two laws, one brings life, the other brings death. And we also learned yesterday that in the Garden of Eden, there was only one law, the law of life. Till Adam made a decision to receive the word from Satan, believe it, and put it into action, and the law of sin got activated. And then we learned also that we are sinners not because we committed sin, but we are sinners because we received the power to commit sin from Adam, who received from Satan. Is that clear?
Yes, yes.
So when Jesus came, he not only came to forgive us our sins, but very important, he came to destroy the sin nature in us. And therefore, when a person receives Jesus as his Lord, God and Savior, and we also learned how does he receive that? When he opens his mouth
and
confesses with his mouth and believes in his
heart.
So everything in the kingdom of God operates through the system. What's the system? Confessing with your mouth, believing in your heart. Again, no, not loudly, softly. Confessing with my mouth
and believing in your heart.
Again.
By confessing with your mouth
and believing in your heart.
So every time I'm speaking, knowingly, unknowingly, the words that I'm speaking is activating the spiritual law. Now, this word, which is the word of faith, we learned is near you. It is in your mouth and in your
heart.
That is the word that is preached, the word of faith that is preached. Praise God. Now, when this word is planted in your heart and the person begins to train his mouth, his mind to continually speak faith, that's the time the person's spirit, before he speaks that word, is loaded with the substance called
faith.
But when the person keeps on speaking yes and no, yes and no, once he speaks faith, the next moment he speaks fear. When that becomes an attitude of a person, okay, the spirit starts getting confused. And that is why when the word is spoken, the word is not mixed with faith. And that's why you don't find Jesus doing yes and no. For him, when it is yes, it's yes, no is no. And that's why when he speaks just one word, it's loaded with faith that it goes and brings forth the manifestation. The same thing was happening with the disciples before Jesus is there. They were yes and no. And that's why Jesus kept rebuking them about their unbelief. When there is unbelief, I am actually with my own mouth activating the spirit of fear, which will come, which will bring destruction in my life. Is that clear?
Yes.
So what's our training from now on? Be extremely alert before you open your mouth and think, what I'm speaking, is it aligning with the word of God? And if you train yourself to do that continuously, now every time the word comes out of your mouth, it comes out mixed with faith. Now, how many times do we speak just casual words? So what happens to our spirit? As it's speaking the word, as we are speaking the word, the spirit is confused. Should I mix faith in this, or is it a casual word? Are you following?
Yes.
So when a person is speaking, by the wounds of Jesus I'm healed. And many times when people ask, how are you? I got this and this and this. Now what happens to the spirit? The word comes from the heart, but it's not mixed with faith. And that's why it is a training that a person has to go through in his personal life, that is very, very vigilant to speak. Praise God. Let's go to Proverbs chapter 4 and I'll show you what it says. Proverbs 4, 22, I think. Look at that verse 23. Can somebody read it? Proverbs 4, 23.
Keep your heart with all vigilance.
Keep your heart with all vigilance.
From it.
From it.
Springs of life. Issues.
Springs of life.
Springs of life or issues of life. Now I'll read it from the Amplified. Keep. Listen. Keep and guard your heart. So who's going to guard your heart?
We have
God or myself?
Myself.
Keep and guard your heart with all vigilance and above all that you guard, for out of it flows the springs of life. So if any person wants to know what's going to be your future, it's so simple. What I plant in my heart is a seed. When I open my mouth and I speak it, it gets planted, and that seed will bring in the harvest. So what's the devil's job? The devil is going to try his best to use our senses so that we begin to reason out and begin to use our five sense gate, out of which the eye and the ear are extremely powerful, because through this sense gate, seeds are planted in the heart. So what you see, you begin to think. What you hear, you begin to think. What you touch and feel, you begin to think. Now this thinking which is going on is slowly opening the gateway for seeds to be planted in your heart. For example, somebody came and told you something. Is it easy for you to recall? Something that is negative.
Yes.
Will it be easy to recall?
Yes.
Come on.
Yes.
For example, Sneha got up from the seat and walked over there. How many of you wanted to see? How many of you wanted to see her? So this is a thank God for the Holy Spirit. He puts everything in the right time. Now, what action you are seeing, is it processing in your mind?
Yes.
So is it opening the sense gate to for things to be planted in the heart?
Yes.
Now the same person is sitting here and is looking at the Bible and start imagining. Is it also getting planted in the heart?
Yes.
So where are you using your imagination? Because it's going to plant in your heart, and then what is planted in your heart, the feelings and the emotions will start triggering and it will come out of your mouth, and now the process has begun, the cycle has begun. So if you have spoken the faith word, the cycle of faith has got activated and the cycle of fear has got deactivated. The preacher cannot stop the cycle in you. The preacher can come and tell you, but it is up to you to open your mouth and speak the word of faith and keep the word of faith going, not open your mouth and speak fear. So the moment you spoke fear, what was growing in your harvest, you went and chopped it off completely, destroying the harvest that is going to manifest very soon. Are you following?
Yes.
So again, the spiritual world is the real world. From the spiritual world comes the physical world. You came from where? From your parents. So all that you see is you. All that you don't see is the parent. So which one is more powerful? The parent. So now if I want to change anything in the physical, I must first change the seeds. Once I get the seeds right, according to the word of God, open my mouth and start speaking, believing and speaking, and start building up my confidence, then those things what you are saying shall come to pass. So are you given the power to create things? God has given man the power to create things. And he has created man out of the dust, and his spirit is a special dust that God has created, that whatever seed you plant, good or bad, the spirit will never discriminate between good and bad. The spirit's job is to make the seed sprout and grow in your life. So if somebody is coming and giving you some negative seeds and you receive it, after some time you find those seeds are growing in you, and slowly but surely the harvest is coming in your life. So when a preacher is coming and speaking the words, what is he doing? He is actually planting seeds. Always remember, when a person comes to a meeting like this, the person is coming and sitting right over there, opening his spirit and saying, now plant the seeds. And that's why it's very important that when you sit for a class like this with your spirit open, you got to be extremely vigilant that the preacher who is planting the seed, if he has planted the seed, it goes right inside, bringing in the wrong harvest. That's why when a person is in trouble and he comes to a counselor and he sits before the counselor, what has he done? He has opened his heart. Now whatever the counselor is saying, he is receiving by paying attention to it. And at that time, if the message was wrong, it got so deeply planted in that person that that person starts behaving in the same way.
Yes.
That's why whenever you come for a class like this, you got to be extremely vigilant that when you have opened your spirit and you know now that this is not according to the word of God, you got to shut it out. Because that seed, when planted, it takes a long time to uproot it. That's why you got to be very choosy. There was once a person with me, and we were in a hotel, and the TV was going on, and the preacher was saying something. And I was sitting, you know, the laptop is here, just, and the preacher is saying something, and I'm just sitting 2 feet from there, and he was behind. And I said, what did he say? I said, I did not hear. He said, what do you mean you did not hear? I said, I don't hear every preacher. What do you mean you don't hear every preacher? I said, he will plant the seed and then I'll have to take a lot of energy to get that seed out. I'm very choosy in listening to whom I want to listen. Because if he's teaching something which will bring confusion in my system, you might be listening to all the preachers. That's why it's become a cocktail. Now you don't know which seed is the right one and which one is the bad one. So he said, you better hear. I said, no, I'm not going to. So we had an argument. And I said, no, because what enters my heart decides my future. And if a preacher is talking something and I'm not sure about that preacher, praise God, I'm not listening. Yeah.
Sorry for the interruption. Though it is the word of God that is going on.
Maybe. No, it is the word of God, but the explanation is not the word of God. I can use the word of God and give you a very close interpretation. Okay. Please. No, okay, I'll give you an example.
My question.
I'll give you, okay.
My question is, I'm in doubt right now, dilemma right now. Because I do not listen to any preachers over there.
Okay.
So am I rejecting the word of God?
No. Listen, Baba, you don't jump to a conclusion. Listen. When I was in a particular place, and I said, Lord Jesus, that person came and said, you should not say Lord. I'll show you from the Bible. Don't ever call Jesus a Lord. Yeah, that's what I'm going there. See, somebody else said, what? There are so many Lords. Matthew chapter 7, verse number 22. Matthew 7:22. Are you ready? Now this is actually that happened. The person came and stopped me and said, you cannot say Lord, Lord. So I say, and he gave me a quotation. Lord, listen. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name have we not cast out devils? And in thy name done many wonderful works? And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Jesus is saying, I never knew you. Depart from me. What is the different concept?
You are not following me, only just saying.
You are pretending to be the disciple, but inside your heart is something else. So if you don't have that relation with yourself.
I did not complete the sentence.
You explain.
No, listen. I did not complete the sentence. That's why you are confused. If I complete the sentence, there will be no confusion.
Yes, right.
That's why I stopped there. And you did not open the Bible because that's why you were thinking, that's all Jesus said.
Yes.
Jesus completed the sentence. Hello. If you take half the sentence, is the message complete?
No.
I'll read it for you half and then I'll read it for you full. Then you give me the answer, okay? And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you, depart from me, you that work iniquity. What? Please understand, the gifts that God gives are irrevocable. Once He gives you, He doesn't take it back. It's given to you forever. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You know why you clapped? Because you believed.
Amen.
And you got so excited and you said, wow. And you responded. Did God notice that?
Yes.
How do you know? You remember about Moses?
Yes.
Now what happened to her? A burning bush.
Yes.
Okay. Now once the gift is given, the person has repented. Now gifts are given when a person repents. Praise God. So the gifts are given, the person repented. Praise God, he changed his life. He is building up his life, he is doing the ministry, everything. Can there be now something called a spiritual pride?
Yes.
Now, when a plant is bearing fruit, does the gardener come and prune the branches?
Yes.
Why is he pruning the branches? You did not understand that. Why is the gardener pruning the branches?
Cut off the bad.
That means you don't know gardening, man. When the branch is bearing fruit, the length of the branch, that much sap has to be supplied. Now once that branch is bound fruit, it's not going to bear that fruit on that same branch. And the sap is going to go waste. So when he cuts that stem, that much sap is saved to be supplied to the other branches. How do I know? Because we used to have coffee plantation. So I used to go and tell him, why are you cutting those big branches? He said, you watch and see. If I don't cut, the branch will be so long and there will be the fruit. But if I cut it here, that one branch will bring 3, 4, 5 small stem, and on every one there will be coffee. The production of the coffee is not on how much manure you put, the art of pruning the plant.
Amen.
So in our spiritual life we are bearing fruit, but while we are bearing fruit there is something called as a spiritual pride that takes place where our flesh is also working slowly but surely. And the gardener will come and chop it. And remember, pruning is always going to be painful. But the result after the pruning is excellent fruit.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So this person came and said, you can't say Lord, Lord. I said, why? If you say Lord, Lord, you're going to hell. I said, where did you get that? And he showed me the scripture. I said, you did not complete what he said. These were the ones who were casting out demons. These were the ones who were prophesying. These were the ones who were doing mighty works. But their personal life was a mess. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
So let's come back to 23. Keep and guard your heart with
all vigilance.
So guarding your heart, can you go to sleep?
No.
No. Can a watchman go to sleep?
No.
If he goes to sleep, the thief will come. In the same way, when you are having conversation with somebody, don't sleep. Be alert that the statement coming by somebody or a sentence coming by somebody is a seed carrying poison, and if I receive it, that poison will start running into my system and everything will become poisonous.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That's why it says, keep and guard your heart with all vigilance, and above all that you guard, for out of it flows issues of life, springs of life. And so if you want to experience life in abundance, it's so simple. What's in your heart? When a person opens his mouth and keeps on speaking, you know what's in the heart. Because out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth
speaks.
Praise God. So now, are you the farmer who is supposed to bring the good things?
Yes.
Can we talk?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
Praise God. Now let me give you one more scripture so that you are sure about your heart. Uh, Matthew 12. Isn't the word of God a treasure hunt?
Yes.
Now is it a fluke game?
No.
Is it a fluke game?
No.
Now you are understanding. Oh my God, all this time I was praying. Yes. But my heart was full of
lies.
Lies of the devil, ignorantly might be, praise God. And wondering, how come my harvest is coming back? So if I am planting weeds and thinking there is going to be rice, because the weed looks like rice.
Yes.
The wild grass. And that's why he also gave the example of the wheat and the tares. I think today we should study on wheat and the tares.
Amen.
We got to study on the wheat and tares. When we come back, we'll study on the wheat and tares. Have you studied that before?
No.
Okay, we'll study that today.
I have touched on it, but not a topic.
I've touched on it. Okay. We'll dig on it now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Okay. Matthew 12:33. Either make the tree good and his fruit good, or else make the tree corrupt and his fruit corrupt. For the tree is known by its leaves.
Roots.
Roots.
Which one is easy to produce, the leaves or the fruit?
Leaves are easy.
And leaves are for whom?
For the tree.
And the fruit is for whom? So remember, leaves represent, just like God giving you gifts of the Holy Spirit. They are free. The moment that person repented, God gives you the gifts of the Holy Spirit, believing in Jesus. But the fruit to produce, you have to labor every day throughout your life. Now, how will a tree produce good fruit?
Pruning, fertilizing, watering.
All wrong.
Cultivate.
How will a person produce good fruit?
When you lose yourself,
I'm talking about the good fruit. I'm not talking about how will the fruit come.
When they're rooted out completely.
Okay, very simple. Okay, let me give a simple example. If a person has got ungodly thoughts, what do you think will be his feelings?
Ungodly.
And if his feelings are ungodly, what do you think will be his decision?
Ungodly.
What do you think will be his action?
Ungodly.
What do you think when the actions are repeated, what will be his habits?
Ungodly.
Now what will be his character?
Ungodly.
Where did it start from?
So
if my thought is wrong, then my fruit will be
wrong.
Now a person might be in good mood and somebody came and said something and you find that the mood is gone. Is that a fruit? Yes. Where did it come from? But the same person, again somebody came and said, and that day he learned about Jairus and Jesus. Jesus telling Jairus, ignore. Jesus himself ignored, disregarded. Give me some more words. Paid no heed. What else?
Believe.
No. I'm talking about Jesus's attitude towards that message.
Disregarded. Shut his ears.
That is not the shut his ears.
Ignored.
What else? Paid no attention.
Yeah.
Overhearing.
Yes.
You know, we that overhearing, we also say to sometimes the husband is having selective hearing. It's good. When everything is bombarded, which is negative, you should have selective hearing. What happened? I did not hear. But the negative things which are not to be heard. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
So, for the tree is known by its fruit. So, might be your fruits are very, very bad at the moment. Can you change the fruits?
Yes.
You got to change the root.
Yes.
What's the root?
Thought.
My thought is a root. Will it produce the fruit? So if the thought is wrong, now if you are thinking something, for example, you might be watching me and saying, has he really combed his hair? Now, if you are thinking all that and I'm giving you the word of God, will you ever produce the fruit that I'm talking to you?
No.
What will you produce?
Ungodly.
Ungodly, it's not ungodly. You will be thinking of the hair.
Yeah.
I might be even bring a comb and give me. But I promise you I will not use it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Every day I have got a different style. You know why? It all depends on the towel.
The way you make your hair is
the style. Okay. Praise God.
Praise God.
Now Jesus say, look at what he's saying. O generation of vipers, how can you being evil speak good things? So where's the evil? In the heart. Because that's where the production goes, the root. For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So when you fill a bucket with water, and it's filling and filling and filling, and then there is a spill. There's a spill. Correct? Even the milk, when you boil and boil and boil, and then there comes a spill. In the same way, when the seeds are planted, whether good or bad, it's boiling inside, and then comes. Anybody married?
Yes.
There is some issue. The seeds have been planted in the heart. And you learnt in the world what to do. If you don't give a piece of your mind, he will come and sit on your head. And somebody told you in the office, don't keep quiet, keep back, otherwise he will sit on your head. So now you are... And he comes. And now you are giving a piece of your mind. And he else is giving... Now what happened? Both of you are in pieces. But if you learn the word of God, what is the word of God saying?
To love.
To love. So to love. Now how many times do we say to love, and how many times do we meditate that even though this person has done this to me, Father, I thank you. I love him. Thank you, Jesus. I love this person. I forgive this person. In the name of Jesus, just as Jesus, you forgive me. I love this person. I love this person. And the person is spending, say, half an hour, 1 hour. Now what's happening? Your heart is getting full. And every day you are doing it. Now when the person really comes in front of you, it is so full that you are able to love that person.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Did you get the formula?
Yes.
But what are we saying? I forgive you in the name of Jesus. How many times you said? Once. And how many things is he bashing you? Now which one is more? In the weighing scale, which one is more? And that's why when he comes, you say you love him, but now you can't love him because now you are retaliating. Because your heart, instead of being abundance of love, it's now abundance of what he said or what he did to you. Is that clear?
Yes.
So do you need to sit in one place like a cow and keep on chewing?
Yes.
And when you're chewing, is your heart going to get filled?
Yes.
Good. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's why that scripture is very powerful. I overcome every evil with good in Jesus' name.
Yes.
That seed is powerful. It can heal your marriage. It can heal relationship. All that you need to do is get your heart overflowing with that scripture.
Amen.
Praise God. Now watch this, what Jesus is saying. A good man, out of the good treasure of the heart, brings forth a good man or a good God?
A good man.
So we're supposed to bring good things in your life.
Yes.
And where are you looking? So is it going to depend on your heart condition or is it going to depend on God's condition? The devil's condition.
Heart condition.
A good man out of the good treasure of the heart brings forth good things, and an evil man of the evil treasure brings forth evil things. Nobody comes in.
No, it's cold. That's why she's closing.
Oh, because it's cold. See how misinterpretation can happen. I'm thinking she's closing the door so that nobody disturbs the class. I'm so happy with her. And the neighbor is interpreting and saying, because she's feeling cold.
Because the wind is coming here.
Wind is coming. Wind is coming. Marina is in the same boat.
No,
about the wind coming. Now, I purposely told Marina something. Could she ignore the seed?
No.
Hello, could she ignore the seed?
No, I
mean,
what
are
you saying?
Yeah. See, this is the class where we do it practical.
Yes.
And I pick up people whom I know will be there in the next class. I will not pick up people whom I will not see in the class anymore.
Hallelujah.
But the same Marina, if she was picked up some 4 years back, you would not have seen her in the class. Because she was very sensitive. Praise God. So every day we got to get more and more stronger. And I'll tell you, if we learn this part, what Jesus did, disregarded, paid no attention,
ignoring,
overhearing, did not give heed to it. If we learn that, how many of our problems can be sorted out by not getting involved?
Yes.
See, when you get involved into an argument, you are watering the plant. Yes. The plant is going to get more and more nourishment, and you will find yourself destroying your own loved one.
Yes.
Because you got your desire, he got his desire, but you want your way, he wants his way. Why not do you say, Lord, not my way, his way, your way. I'm going to only look at you. Now, you know, have you ever heard this? The battle belongs to the Lord.
Yes.
And you might be praying, the battle belongs to the Lord. But when the argument starts, who is battling?
We are battling.
But who is opening the mouth? Did Jesus open his mouth?
No.
And did he win?
Yes.
Which one is better? Keep your mouth shut and speak faith? Or open your mouth and put and speak lies of the devil? And when you begin to do that, you find yourself not only defeated, miserable, and you become a cause of destroying the whole family. The devil's strategy. Thanks for the silence in the class. Everybody's silent. Praise God.
Praise
God. So shall we learn to ignore?
Yes.
Disregard?
Yes.
But don't ignore the person.
The words.
Ignore the words. Love the person. And when you do not retaliate and you continue to ignore, God gets into the battle. Because God has promised you, I will exalt the humble. A humble person is a one who does not retaliate, does not give offense, or does not take offense. A humble person is a person who is all the time longing to be the doer of the word. He's always teachable. He doesn't give excuses. why we come late, the bus. So what did you say? I was not the one responsible, the bus was. But the moment you say, yes, I am responsible for it, but next time, I'll see to it that I come 20 minutes early. Yes. So now, are you teachable?
Yes.
But you find people who are giving excuses, don't waste your time. Because for everything they have got excuse. In other words, they are saying, I'm not willing to change. Praise God. And when you become humble and everybody is bashing you up, it looks like your game is over. But you are the Joseph over there. Might be in the pit. Might be in the Egyptian master's house. Yes. Might be in the prison. But God's eyes are fixed on those who are humble. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Will he exalt you? You know, when a person is humble and God exalts you, he gives you a position of honor, nobody can touch it.
Yes, the Lord. Oh.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But when I am retaliating, I'm in pride. And the Bible says, God rebukes the pride. So you must be saying, demon, get out of me. Or demon, get out of this. And God is saying, it's not the demon. I am the one who is fighting against you because of your pride. So the devil's job is to get us into pride. God's, the Holy Spirit, is to get us into
humble.
So the choice is us. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So you can write down some points. And then we go, come back and study on wheat and tares.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
You want to study that?
Yes.
Because then you will understand how the enemy plans to destroy us. So let's study strategy and let's be alert and vigilant that we don't give into those strategies. Praise God. Okay, this is the notes for yesterday, last night, what we learned. Just write down some notes. Faithful words are more powerful. Faith-filled words are more powerful. Than the power in the law of sin and death. Than the power in the law of sin and death. In the law of sin and death. In the law of sin and death. If the classroom was big, this would be the better than there.
Yeah.
No?
Yes.
I know, because you all are all feeling warm.
No, we are all for ourselves. Good disturbance.
Okay. We can know what God will do. We can know what God can do. Can somebody say why? Because God always works through
principles.
Spiritual
principles.
Laws. So if there is an insulation, I can touch the wire. If there is no insulation, then that wire can kill me. So in the same way, once I know that these words are laws of faith, I plan them, I activate them, I'm sure it's going to work in my behalf. Because God is in action. But if I'm speaking and believing and planting the wrong seeds in my heart, I'm also sure that this is going to lead to destruction. Everything in the law of the Spirit, everything.
Okay.
I did not complete. Oh, sorry. I like that. You can know what God will do because He operates by spiritual laws. Because He operates by spiritual laws. Because He operates by spiritual laws. Everything in the law of the Spirit of life, everything in the law of Spirit of life in Christ Jesus,
Spirit.
in the spirit of life. Why the spirit of life in Christ Jesus? In the Garden of Eden there was a spirit of life. But then God activated the spirit of sin and death. So Jesus came, obeyed the Father and activated again the spirit of life, which is activated in Christ Jesus. Again and again, 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 again.
In the beginning was the law of life.
In the beginning was the law of life, because God spoke the word and the spirit of life got into action. Satan came into the scene and gave the words of lies. Adam disobeyed God, obeyed the lie and activated the law of sin and death. So Jesus came into the scene as man and he obeyed. Adam disobeyed. So Jesus obeyed God, and so the word obeyed, and that obedience activated now once again the law of life, the spirit of life. But this law now is operating in Christ Jesus, and that Christ Jesus is in us. And therefore now when you open your mouth and you speak his word, that law just activates, destroying the law of sin and death.
Amen.
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 Can you just say that lightly? Could
we write that down?
That's what I'm talking.
Okay.
Okay. I don't know. Okay. Let's try.
Just the light in the beginning.
In the beginning.
Life was.
In the beginning, God spoke the word. In the beginning, God spoke the word. And the spirit of life created all things. Created all things. And everything was good. In the Garden of Eden. Satan used words that contradicted God's word. Satan used words that contradicted God's word Adam received those words. Adam received that lie, words of lies, and disobeyed God. And so, an opposite law of sin and death, an opposite law of sin and death got activated in the Garden of Eden. Got activated in the Garden of Eden, bringing death, sickness, disease, sorrow, curse.
Death,
sickness, disease,
lack,
sorrow,
lack,
grief,
lack,
poverty, rejection, everything from the kingdom of darkness. Jesus came as man faced every temptation and test
you.
faced every temptation and test, even to the point of death, obeyed his father and activated the law of life.
Actually, he reactivated it.
He activated the law of life.
In himself.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
So the law of life is not active by itself. The law of life is active now in Christ Jesus. And that's why you take the name of Jesus. That's the authority. That's the power. That's the power of attorney. Praise God.
Have you completed the name that you were given?
No, last line also there was. Now when you use these words and...
The law of life in Christ Jesus, and then you were supposed to write something. But no, what you were doing? Everything is the spirit of life in Christ Jesus.
So now he has activated the laws.
That's not what you are giving him.
So you have given the outcome
this
also.
That's what we can know that God will do, because he operates by spiritual laws. He operates by spiritual laws. Means what? The world.
After that, you gave a line.
Okay.
The explanation is
clear. Spiritual law.
The whole system is operating on Jesus. Everything is kept together in Jesus. But because we are having the power to speak like God, what are we doing? We are opening our mouth, the world is opening their mouth and speaking words of destruction.
Is it connected to Romans 8:1?
Yeah, there is no condemnation.
Those who do not walk in the flesh.
No, there is no condemnation.
Not for everybody.
Only those who don't walk in the flesh.
Only to those who do not walk in the flesh. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So that's why Jesus said you are the light. Why? Because when you open your mouth and speak, where there's darkness, your words can go and bring light. You are the salt of the earth. Means what? You are not being seen, but the taste of Jesus in you can be tasted.
Amen.
Because when you put salt in the gravy, you can never see the salt, but you can
taste,
you can experience the taste. In the same way, we are not to be seen, but Christ in us is magnified when people see our attitudes. Praise God. Hallelujah. Okay, everything in the law of the spirit of life.
This is what you're doing.
So give me a chance to speak. Everything in the law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus works by faith. Just put that line, very, very important. Works by faith. Everything in the law of the spirit of life. Everything in the law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus. In Christ Jesus works by faith. Now the moment you said faith, always remember you are believing in things not seen. So everywhere you go around, the circumstances, the situations, the relationship, the marriage, the children and everything that you're going through, you are able to see things going in the opposite direction. So the law of sin and death is extremely active in your loved one or the situation. Now, for you to reverse, all you need to do is open your mouth and speak faith. And that's why the Lord teaches us, let the weak
say.
Why say? Because faith is activated by saying.
Confessing.
You confess with your mouth, believe in your heart that you are strong, then you will experience you are being made strong, because your job is to believe and speak, and the Spirit of God will bring it to manifestation. Is that good?
Yes.
So from now on, are you going to speak what you see or what you want to see?
What I want to see.
Softly. Are you going to speak about your problems, or are you going to speak the solution?
Solution.
Can you speak softly? There's a mass going on. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now those who are watching might be saying, he's not going for mass. No, it's going on in Gujarati. He will have it in English. Because everything can be picked up in a wrong message.
Yes.
And when it comes to me, there are telescope, microscope and all scope. Hallelujah. Okay, everything in the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus works by faith. Example, healing, divine health, prosperity, deliverance, being born again, baptism in the Holy Ghost, redemption power, next line, everything that's under curse, brings fear. That is sin, sickness, demons, fear, poverty, disaster. So write down in bold capital letters, we must understand. Let him come. Whoever wants to come, just walk in. If somebody wants to come, just tell that person, come in.
We must understand.
There is. We must understand. There is a faith in God. There is a faith in God. And there is an opposite faith. And there is an opposite faith in fear and death. And there is an opposite faith in fear and death. Example, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Fear comes by hearing lies of the devil. Which one will I meditate on? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
We thank you.
We thank you.
Softly, softly. We thank you.
Thank you.
We praise you.
Praise you.
Teaching us this truth.
Lord,
help us to teach our mind.
Help us to teach our mind.
Our tongue. Our heart. To believe.
To believe.
And speak your word only.
And speak your word only.
Lord.
In our life.
We have spoken so many words of fear. That they are growing in the spiritual realm. Manifesting in the physical realm.
Heavenly Father.
In the name of Jesus.
Let there be a supernatural
destruction
in the spiritual realm
of all those negative words
that has come out of my mouth.
Words of fear.
Destroy them.
Make them powerless.
In Jesus' name.
By faith I believe.
By faith I believe.
The spirit of fear. And all the consequences
have completely been deactivated.
Terminated.
From the root.
And the words of faith.
Have been activated.
In Jesus' name.
I believe it.
I have spoken it.
I have received it.
And it has manifested.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Praise God.
Just